We are honored to have Dr. Sarish Krishna Rao, a Shining World Award for Earth Protection Laureate, on our program to answer our questions regarding climate change and religion, as well as the spiritual considerations behind his work. Dr. Sarish Krishna Rao graduated in 1986 from Stanford University, USA, receiving a PhD in electrical engineering. For the first 20 years after graduation, he actively served society as a system specialist and was involved in the creation of new communication technology in support of the internet. Though extremely successful in his professional career, he was inspired to make a significant change after watching former Vice President Al Gore's presentation about global warming in December 2005. Dr. Rao then founded the non-profit organization Climate Healers in 2007.
I started Climate Healers in 2007. It's really about reversing climate change and healing the climate, bringing the earth back to the Eden that she was before we started our agricultural practices and our industrial revolution. So it's returning earth back to its pristine nature as much as possible. Okay, when we do that, then automatically climate change goes away. So climate becomes what it was before, and the animals come back, you know, the whole ecosystem heals. Climate change is really like the fever that the earth has. And the underlying cancer is the violence that we are committing on Earth. So it's going to a non-violent world, which would cause the healing to happen. We did four documentaries so far. The first was The Human Experiment, which talked about all the chemical pollution of the planet. Then Cowspiracy, The Sustainability Secret, where we showed how, you know, environmental organizations are not talking about one of the leading causes of environmental destruction, which is animal agriculture. Then we did Water Health, where we showed that, you know, it's causing so many diseases and the government doesn't want to talk about it. The pharmaceutical companies are making money off all these diseases. So it establishes the fact that we have a system in which we are making, you know, money out of death, disease and destruction. And every one of these things is producing revenues for some corporation or the other. And so we are stuck in this system of normalized violence. We literally have to now create a new system of normalized nonviolence, where everything we do helps the planet, helps us to be healthy, and doesn't kill the animals. So it's a very simple concept in that sense.
Dr. Rao has promised his granddaughter Kimaya that the world will be largely vegan before she turns 16 in 2026.
So that people will stop eating her relatives, the animals.
So currently, he is working on the transformation to a compassionate vegan world by 2026 through a concept known as normalizing nonviolence. He has a firm belief that humans have a glorious origin and can restore the planet once it realizes their true nature.
So that gives us a deadline, or really it's literally like a lifeline, you know. And so once we know that we need to achieve this in the next 8 years, we'll work on it. So this is what we are doing. We have a conference in Phoenix 2 weeks ago, where we basically, people got together and we identified questions that we have about how do we make this transition. And then we started answering those questions. So this is exactly how the internet was also created. You know, basically we found where there were gaps in the knowledge, but how do we do the connection? And we worked on creating best practices for that. Basically, you know, if you ask most people, they're already fundamentally nonviolent. You know, no one really wants to kill animals unnecessarily. So it's part of our nature already, okay? Except that there are forces that are doing all this killing for us. And then we just get the product of that violence, and people are asked to consume that. So in effect, we are unconsciously causing all this violence to happen. So when we normalize nonviolence, basically a vegan world, that's what we're talking about, it's in alignment with who they really are, because they already were nonviolent to begin with, right? So it, I think in that sense, it's really coming back into alignment with who we are. And so in that sense, it's easy for people to get to.
Let's pause for a while. We'll be right back after a short message. Welcome back, noble viewers. After many years of actively raising people's awareness about the environmental issues, respected Dr. Serisau had a profound insight regarding the root cause of climate change.
And the goal was to reverse climate change. And then when you study the problem, you realize that it is a very spiritual problem, because the foundation of sustainability is really compassion for all life. And so is the foundation for all religion, is compassion for all life. And it's the foundation for all ethics, is compassion for all life. So it turns out that going to a sustainable world is really going back to our ethical roots, you know, and our religious roots, and taking them seriously. So it's compassion for all life is at the core of it all. It's really about compassion. It's about compassion in action. That's what religion is about, you know. No matter which religion you talk about, our stories are different. The words we use are different, but our actions are the same. It's about peace. It's about love. It's about justice, right? It's about compassion.
In Dr. Rao's opinion, other practitioners of different world religions have the responsibility to uphold compassion and apply it in their life. He hopes that more young people paying attention to the practical side of life will be moved and inspired by religion.
So, from a spiritual point of view, what the world needs is for all the religions of the world, all the religious practitioners of the world, to realize that getting to sustainability is a religious issue. Okay, it is a religious issue. It's about living in accordance with who we really are, what we say. So its principles are like buses, you know. We need to take the principles where they go, you know. And so if we talk about compassion for all life, it should be compassion for all life in every action. So when it is unnecessary to eat animal foods, we should stop that. When it's unnecessary to wear animal skins, we should stop that. When it's unnecessary to experiment on animals, we should stop that. So we know that our religions are talking about compassion at our very core, so which means that we can practice it. So it is about coming into alignment with the tenets of our religions. So when all the religious communities around the world practice what they are preaching, then the world will be fine. The transformation has to be led by the religious communities of the world, because the religious communities of the world are creating community in their local areas, you know. And the community comes together, then they can support each other. They can have vegan potlucks. They can have demonstrations of how to create vegan food. So when they get together and do that for the good of all, not only the good for the health of the people, but for the health of the animals and for the health of the planet. And when they do that, then it becomes much more relevant. The religion becomes much more relevant, and the young people then become inspired by religion, because right now they're shying away from religion, right? So then they see that there is something practical about religion, about the religions of the world, and then they will join, and they will join enthusiastically, okay? So this is a way to revive faith around the world.
For more information about Dr. Sarish Rao and climate healers, please visit www.climatehealers.org.
All information concerning the scientific evidence of climate change and its solution is in Supreme Master Qinghai's book, From Crisis to Peace. Free to download at crisistopeace.org.
Great viewers, thank you for joining us on today's episode of Rebuilding the Foundation of Sustainability Through Compassion, an interview with Dr. Sarish Krishna Rao, part 1 of 3, on Words of Wisdom.